We are springing forward this weekend, and with the time change comes another renewed effort from lawmakers to make daylight saving time permanent. Fox 31's Talya Cunningham joins us in studio, new at 9.
Well, Andrea, Colorado has been pushing to make daylight saving time permanent for decades now. In fact, Governor Jared Polis signed a bill in June of last year to do just that. But the reason we aren't following it right now is a change in a 1966 federal law requiring it. So in addition to that, the bill mandates that 4 other states in the Mountain Time Zone agree to that switch. So if you take a look at this map that's going to pop up right here behind me, the green, Utah, Montana, and Wyoming are already on board with this. That means if the federal government gives a green light on this, only one more state has to adopt daylight saving time. That's in the yellow. That would be Arizona, New Mexico, and Idaho. That brings us to the Sunshine Protection Act, which would make the time change permanent all across the country. So it passed in the U.S. Senate last year, but it actually stalled in the House, not moving forward. So now there's a renewed push this year, but it's still unclear if Congress plans to take it up. There is some support and there is some opposition tonight. Advocates argue the extra hour of light could boost economic activity, improve people's moods, and increase exercise. But some medical professionals say it could lead to an increase in car accidents, heart attacks, and strokes, disrupting the body's internal clock.
We're against it for several reasons, primarily due to health and public safety.
We want an hour more for kids, farmers, people that want to stay outside, work in the yard. I think people deserve that.
So a survey published last year by Monmouth University found 61% of Americans would like to get rid of the twice a year time change. Of course, we'll have to wait and see how this go around plays out. In studio tonight, Talya Cunningham, Fox 31. Yeah.